Before I get into today's episode about Jelani Tavai, I just want to let you guys know that today's episode is sponsored by SeatGeek. You can save $20 off on your first purchase just if you use the promo code JKS, and it's a great way to get tickets to concerts, sporting events, and anything of that nature. So if it's something you're interested in, the link is in the description below, and again, that's the promo code JKS to get $20 off your first purchase. And anyways, back to your regularly scheduled video. One of the clear things the Detroit Lions have tried to do this offseason is really bolster the run defense. They really want to make sure that opposing teams can't run the ball against them, which I think is really smart. With the way play action is becoming more and more important, if you can't run the ball, you can't run play action as well, which means that you can't throw the ball as well. And while, of course, the two big ways they've gone about getting a better defense is by getting Trey Flowers and also by getting Mike Daniels, you know, those are the two biggest names they've acquired this past offseason. But one real underrated move, in my opinion, was the fact that they drafted Jelani Tavai in the third round. He's a guy who he can play. I mean, you know, he's perfect size for a linebacker, in my opinion, at 6'2", 249 pounds. Right around there is really where you want a linebacker to be. But most importantly, he's just a really good athlete. That's what I really like about him, and that's why I think the Detroit Lions did decide to draft him. So I was definitely planning on making a video about him about the preseason, and I'll start things off with this one. It's going to be a cover 3 zone, and that's where Tavai is on the screen. So, you know, he's in charge of covering the zone that's second closest to the bottom half of the screen. And this is actually important because Houston has a tight end who's going to be running right there. So, you know, it'll be in a gap in coverage, and it'll also be underneath where Tavai is supposed to be guarding. So this is definitely a great situation for Houston to try to just pick up some yards. And if you look after the ball is snapped, that tight end is just about to turn, just about to make his cut, and he is going to be open. I mean, if you look at both Tavai and the other Detroit Lions defender, I mean, they are not close enough to be making a play on this one. So should you blame Tavai for not being able to cut in and be able to make a play on this one? Well, maybe you could, but at the same time, you don't want to give up the middle of the field and allow a play to go in that direction. If you are playing cover 3, this now means that you do have to make sure you're playing close to the middle of the field and pretty far back, just in case they do try to run a play through the middle of the field. You know, a lot of guys do try to make plays right in that center of the field, especially in a cover 2, but oftentimes in a cover 3 as well. So to stay far back deep is definitely something you might want to do in a lot of situations. However, in this situation, it's going to play to his disadvantage. To me, I'm not really worried about that too much. I mean, that is kind of a tough play, and, you know, those types of things happen. The tackling on this play wasn't great from Detroit. I mean, you see there was plenty of yards after the contact on that one, almost like 5 or 6 yards after the contact, which I don't love. But it's also kind of hard to put all that on Tavai. As much as you would like to just come in and make a big hit, I mean, when you're the second man in, if you do make a big hit, that's how people get hurt, and that's also how flags are thrown. It's not a bad play by any means, but a play maybe he didn't go above and beyond in any way. I definitely wouldn't blame Tavai for that one. If I wasn't making a video on Tavai, I probably wouldn't have even brought him up really on that one, because, you know, he didn't really have a huge impact on the play. But, you know, sometimes you just make an okay play, and that's what he did there. And you know what? Okay plays are fine. But anyways, let's get off the okay plays, and let's get on to a very good play. This one might have actually been my favorite play of the night, and here's how it's going to work. That's where Tavai is on the screen, and he's going to have a right guard move up to try to block him. So that's the way this play is going to work from Tavai's perspective. And one thing you'll see after this ball is snapped is, for one thing, look at how much lower Tavai is here. That's what you want to do. You want to make sure you're getting low. I'll bring that up a little bit more in a couple of plays later on, but I mean, he's definitely lower at this point, so he can kind of control what he wants to do. And it is going to be a run to the bottom half of the screen, by the way. So for Tavai, he's trying to get over to the bottom half of the screen. That's what he's trying to do here. So he's going to have to make sure he gets off his block, and one way he's going to do that is by getting his right arm and just getting it basically right onto that shoulder pad right there that Texan has, and kind of just push as hard as he can. This allows him to still be able to move over a little bit to the bottom half of the screen, but it also frees up his left arm. Because now watch what he's going to do. He's going to now reach out with his left arm while still using his right arm to push off of that guard. So, you know, he is able to latch his hand on, but again, you're now trying to make a one-handed tackle against a halfback, and, you know, that's not easy to do. But then he has the strength to pull it off. I mean, that's just an all-around tremendous play. I definitely do feel like that's where Tavai is going to shine. You know, he kind of did his part in the passing game, and the reason why I brought up that first play wasn't so much just to show, oh, hey, he made an okay play, because really, who cares? The real reason I brought it up was just to show that he can be somewhat effective in the passing game, and that's fine. That's all really you have to do if you are an effective run stopper, and he is a very effective run stopper. You know, as long as he can just do his part in the passing game, he can really thrive in stopping the run. And this play was also kind of another example. It's going to be play action, actually, so it doesn't really matter too much, but I still thought it was a good example of showing just his strengths. What Houston is going to do is they're going to move a fullback up, and then they are going to run play action, and Tavai is in charge of basically just taking out the fullback if it was going to be a run. And now there's something I like about this play and something I don't like about this play. The first thing is, he saw it was a run, and he did a very good job of taking that fullback out of the play. However, that's not the only thing that happened on that play. If you watch it, that was actually zone coverage, and because Tavai broke in, that led Hopkins to be wide open. Those are the types of plays he's going to have to clean up, in my opinion. I mean, listen, you can stop the run with the best of them, but you are going to have to make sure that you clean up those types of mistakes, because that just allowed a free completion right there. But again, there is something I like about that play too. He did, in my opinion, a very good job of just taking away that fullback. So, you know, if he guessed right, I would have said good job, but you know, he was wrong on that play. And you have to try to not get beat as much as possible. That's going to be a key thing in the NFL, is just knowing if it's going to be a pass or a run. There's also one more play that I didn't really love from Tavai, and it's going to be this one. What's going to happen for Houston is they're going to have their center and left guard both double-team that Detroit line right there. And then their left tackle will just have a one-on-one matchup, and then they're simply just going to send their halfback to try to get straight through that gap. They only need 1 yard since this is a 4-from-1, so that's what they're going to try to do here. So that's where Tavai comes in. You know, if he sees that there is going to be a gap that's going to be open, he should just try to shoot that gap and clog it up. You know, it's 4th and 1, so make a play. It's worth the risk, in my opinion. The chances are if they get this first down, they're getting a touchdown anyways. So try to make the play and try to turn the ball over right now. And as you see, once this ball snapped, he's just not close enough to the line at this point. I mean, the halfback and Tavai are basically the same distance away from that first down marker right there, which is just not a good situation. He also should be a little bit closer to the top half of the screen than he is. So, you know, I would have liked to see him get a little bit more aggressive on this play. Because as you see, it's just not going to work out. They're not going to be able to stop him short of the first down marker. If he got there a little bit quicker, he might have been able to. Again, that's the safe play, because if you do try to shoot the gap and you run up through the wrong gap, then it's a touchdown. So, you know, I do get the flip side to a degree. But personally, I'm just from the school of thought of, I would rather see you try to make a play. I remember back when I played baseball, there was a lot of guys on a team that were playing a little bit timidly. You know, if there was a ball, they weren't sure if they were going to catch or not, they would just let it bounce on one hop and not allow a double or anything. And my coach didn't like that, and so he told everyone, hey, dive, try to make a play, you know, figure some way out to get to the ball. And then there was one game when there was a ball that was like that situation, there was a line drive, I wasn't sure if I was able to get to it, I dove, and I didn't get it, and so I was like, oh man, I screwed everything up. But after that play, even though it got an extra base hit instead of a single because the ball did roll past me, we still did get out of the inning. And when I got back to the dugout, my coach actually said, hey, good job, Jackson. Way to try to make a play. And that's always kind of stuck with me. And that's kind of the coaching model that I would probably implement today if I were a coach, is to do something like that. Regardless of the sport, I want you to be aggressive. I want you to try to make plays because that's how you win games. And again, for all I know, that's what Matt and Patricia wants. Matt Patricia wants them to be a little bit more cautious in those types of situations, so I shouldn't be blaming him. But you know, it's just a play that stood out to me, and so that's why I'm bringing it up. And it also is worth mentioning, we kind of expect these types of smaller mistakes happening from Tavai. I mean, he's a rookie. That's what we expect to see happen. If he wasn't making these mistakes, we'd be talking about him as a Defensive Rookie of the Year candidate. I mean, he's going to make some mistakes. That's just the reality of the situation. But at the same time, let's not focus on maybe where he needs some improvement. Let's focus on what makes him great, because he is great at one thing, and that's stopping the run. And when he knows it's a run, he can definitely be very impactful. Like, take a look at this play, for example. Houston is going to have the right guard and right tackle double-team that Detroit Lion right there in the middle of the screen. They're actually going to pull their left guard all the way over, and he's going to be the one who's going to be blocking Tavai. He's lead blocking on this play. And so, as you see, you know, he's getting in position, and Tavai is also getting in position to try to take him out. And, you know, again, for Tavai, you'd think this is not a favorable matchup at all. I mean, you know, we already said his height and weight at 6'2", around 250. Tytus Howard is 6'5", and 322. So, you know, 3 inches and 70 pounds, that's a tough situation for Tavai. But what I like about this from Tavai is look at how low he's gonna get. You know, pad level really is everything, and his pad level is very low here, which is what you want to do, especially when you are a shorter guy. And again, he's not short, but just against an offensive lineman, it's just a favorable matchup for an offensive lineman. But another thing I like about this too is look at how his legs are bent over, and look at how his body is sort of tilted. He's leading with his left shoulder right there, which is not going to allow Howard to push him out of the way too much, and Tavai can kind of just stay where he's at. So when the halfback does try to get past him, Tavai is still able to reach his arm out and make a tackle. I'm sorry, but that's a tough situation when you're an offensive coordinator and you're trying to game plan against the Detroit Lions, and they have a linebacker who can even win one-on-one matchups against offensive linemen. That's just tough. And of course, if you can win one-on-one matchups against offensive linemen, you can own one-on-one matchups against tight ends or fullbacks, and I'll show you what I mean with this play. Houston has a fullback in the game. This is actually, again, a much taller guy here. I mean, it's Jordan Thomas. He's 278 pounds, so, you know, 20 to 30 pounds on Tavai, but he's also 6'6". So yeah, you know, 4 inches on Tavai, so what should Tavai do? Well, he should get low. And again, watch how low he is. I mean, that just, again, his legs are so far bent over, and he's so far bent forward as well. For Thomas, if you have 4 inches on Tavai and he's getting this low, you're not going to get higher than him. You're just not. And so when you're lower than a tall guy, what's going to happen when you do this? Well, he's going to kind of shoot up. He's going to basically be standing flat-footed. And once he does that, that's when you can really control what you want to happen. So watch how right when he shoots up, Tavai is able to ferociously just get into this play. I mean, that's just winning your one-on-one matchup. You even see Thomas kind of shake his head a little bit. He's like, man, I don't know how I could have stopped that one. I mean, that was just a great play from Tavai. I mean, he's just kind of one of those guys where he's a pest, you know? That's the thing about Tavai. That's why I would hate to play against Tavai, because I feel like he would be annoying. There's certainly better linebackers out there in the league, but he's just one of those guys you don't want to have to deal with. Like, even on this play, he's going to get beat, but it'll still be a good play from him. And here's what's going to happen. That's where he is on the screen, and it'll be a right tackle who's going to be running up to make this block. And so after the ball is snapped, I mean, that's, again, he got a little bit surprised on that one. You know, it happens, but that is what happened. Tavai wasn't able to get low the way he wanted to. That Texans tackle has both his hands on Tavai's shoulder pads. So it's a bad situation from Tavai, and he got a little bit surprised. So, you know, it happens. We all expect those kind of things to happen, especially in the preseason. You know, he hasn't yet gotten used to the NFL-level talent just quite yet. Sometimes guys will surprise you. It happens. But watch his hustle from this one. Watch how he just fights to find a way to get into the play. I mean, again, you love to see that if you're a coach. So, you know, yeah, I mean, maybe his technique isn't quite perfect just yet. I mean, let's be honest, if it was, why would he even be playing in the preseason? He's a rookie and he'll get better, so I'm not really too worried about those kind of things just yet. You know, one of my favorite Bill Belichick quotes is, "Tell me what the guy can do, don't tell me what he can't do, and we'll find a way to put that positive skill set in the defense and not ask him to be in a position where he can fail." Honestly, I think that quote is just brilliant in a lot of ways, not just in football, but I think that actually matters a lot in life as well. If you're a leader, you're not getting the most out of your people if you're putting people in positions where they can fail. I mean, let's be honest. But yeah, I mean, it's kind of cool to see that, yes, the things that he could dominate in college, he can still do very well at the NFL level. At least that's my opinion. I'd like to know what you guys think. And as always, thanks for watching.